How will Jupiter in Capricorn speak to you and your sign? Find out at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous superstar Sagittarius. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of December 2019. Looking at life and love, I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. Now, it is going to be in the middle of the month that another person is going to come into focus. There can be a love way to understand this energy, and I'll save that for just in a little bit. But this can represent business partnerships as well, professional alliances as well. Wherever it is that you are allied or aligned with another person one-on-one, well, it is there that some confusion may be possible, especially in the days around the full moon, which takes place around the 12th of the month. So it is at this time when it can feel as if you're not certain as to whether or not the information you're getting is accurate from a particular partner. It's possible that you may have some doubts or questions as well, and you feel like you're not getting the answers or sensing the right answers for you. Now, regardless of what it is that might be transpiring at this time, I would say it is important, if you can help it, not to make any major agreements with partners or to align with a partner as well. Not to put all of your sense of your prosperity in the hands of another at this time, especially when you're not sure how it is that that is going to be handled. Because whether it's confusion, whether it is disappointment because of your partnership with another facilitating a disappointment, I'm so sorry, but that is possible at this time, as well as a lack of clarity, meaning that sometimes that lack of clarity is unintentional, but sometimes it can be intentional as well. Again, I'm sorry to say that, but it does happen and it is possible. Whatever it is that does show up for you at this time, allow the moment and the time to sort of navigate, because on the other side, you become a lot more clear as to the best pathway forward for you in terms of a key alliance. It is possible at this time that a particular alliance does dissolve, and that really would be okay as well. Regardless, just know that all is not clear at the full moon, but very shortly after it is. Now, what is happening this month that is really very big? The big news, of course, is early in the month, Jupiter will leave your sign and will move into a financial part of your sky, bringing financial blessings in the 12 plus months to come. Now, this move technically happens right around the second of the month. Be on the lookout in the first days of December for a Jupiter special on YouTube, and also, of course, Jupiter specials on my website as well. But for all that, we've got truly very exciting energy here. There is a sense now of you taking all of the stuff that you learned about yourself, all of the ways in which you have gone through changes, expanded your self-definition, and truly expanded and transformed your horizons in key ways over the course of the 13 months leading up to this. Well, now you're going to have all of that count for something in your financial life, and you're going to set about actually creating money out of the new understandings that you have had. And if you want to know how good it can be, how well things could be, well, just wait to this month's solar eclipse. Right around Christmas Day is when we are going to have a solar eclipse. Now, normally when the sun meets Jupiter in the sky, this is considered the luckiest day of the year. But what we have now is a solar eclipse meeting Jupiter in the sky. That brings that much more energy and electricity and excitement and surprise to this very, very fortunate meeting. And so this looks like out of nowhere, very surprisingly out of nowhere, a new opportunity, a big opportunity can show up for you, or at the very least, an opportunity to understand where it is that you're ready to move towards greater prosperity. On the other hand, this can be a real breakthrough where it comes to self-esteem and self-worth, and where it is that you're ready to align with principles of healthy self-love, which could end up being more valuable than any money that you might gain at this time. Now, where it comes to matters of love, we do have some very interesting energy around that full moon. On the one hand, there is energy of uncertainty, maybe having to look at some of your own fears. but also this can represent some sense of maybe a partner not being straightforward with you. And in some cases as well, this can be a disillusionment as well, or a dissolvement at this time. For those of you open to meeting someone new, it may very well be that at this full moon, you are encouraged to look at your own fears or your own uncertainties around love and the possibility of love in your life. Whatever does come up, remember, we have a lot of illusionary energy. So it isn't necessarily that your sense of an emotional wave that you may be riding at this time has any value. But the value is to be able to look at yourself and your own fears and to heal that in your journey towards greater love than you've known before. For those of you just starting to date somebody, I do think this full moon is going to be consequential in helping you to understand whether or not you're meant to or want to move forward with this person. If there is any lack of transparency, that is going to start to show up around the full moon as well. But where it is as well that perhaps it doesn't feel like this is something that you're meant to move forward with, well, those feelings will arise, as well as you being willing to make a decision in the middle of the month. And for those of you who are in an established bond, this particular full moon can bring with it some emotional circumstances around your partner. And I know that that isn't necessarily easy, but even the most stable bonds at this time can feel as if there is some kind of flux taking place. Now, whatever it is, it really is okay. Remember, because it's just a moment and you find yourself on the other side of this energy. But for all that, really the power of this time is you being rooted in self-esteem and self-worth. And where it is that you are finding your partner needs you to be present, well, you will find a way to do just that and to navigate whatever you may feel at this time as part of understanding each other more deeply. Now, this may not play out in romantic relationships, a full moon like this. Sometimes it can be that the relationship itself is stable and strong and sure, but some of this flux is playing out more in terms of a business partnership or alliance as well. So it's important to keep that in mind at this time. But for all that, it is going to be right around the 20th of the month that Venus will change signs and move into a very communicative part of the sky. And going forward from there, it becomes so much easier to talk to your partner about just about anything and to find a new understanding. What I love about this month for you, well, look, it's gotta be Jupiter. It's gotta be money, right? Jupiter is going to be speaking in supreme harmony with Uranus in a rare alignment happening right around the 15th. But the sweet spot of this energy is December 8, 9, 10. This is a more proactive energy. If you want to put anything into place that you hope will create more prosperity to you, or just be open to brainstorming, chances are what starts out as a little kernel, as a little possibility, takes off, or even better, by the time we get to that amazing solar eclipse right around Christmas Day. That solar eclipse is filled with magic and possibility and hope for you and a more prosperous self-concept and a more prosperous future as well. Well, thank you so much for watching. I don't know if you realized, but Biggie was really being very hyper there for a moment. I don't know what was going on. You know how it is when you have a pet. But that was fun. I decided to leave it in. I hope that you enjoyed his little antics in the background. Now he's just sort of off camera, but he's okay. He's fine. He calmed down on his own. I didn't want to stop his exuberance, you know? But anyways, thank you for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiyaShah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.